Hello everyone. In this video, I'll be attacking Tunnels of Apocalypse. If you read the text here, we can see it comes from Mystery Patron. So the captain, or myself if you prefer, he had a dream that was invaded by Mystery Patron. So if you check the research that came out of that dream, we can read that your dreams have been brutally invaded by a strange woman, the Mystery Patron. She said some things about fighting evil for her in exchange for some teachings. Now, should you write it off as a mere dream or give in to the madness and ask about her at the Bounty Hunters Guild? And after researching the bounty hunt for Mystery Patron, I've decided to take up the cooperation with the Mystery Patron. It seems to be the only way to figure out who she is and what her real motives are anyway. And maybe her teachings might be worth a dime. Sure enough, there was an application waiting at the Bounty Hunt network. So she's recognized as an official Booty Hunt customer. She does not offer any tokens, but writes that you need to pass three different tests of Brains, Brawl and Sway before most of her teachings even start to make sense. Figures, war comes first and then pay. Well, you'll make sure it's extracted one way or another. Now we can see that Tunnels of Apocalypse have a despawn penalty of 50. And if you check it out, we can read that it came from Mystery Patron. And the text is, "My champion, it is time for your trial of sway. The cult of Apocalypse is using this site to summon demons. I believe a certain artifact called Grimoire of Transfiguration is responsible. You must capture this item if we are to stand any chance at stopping them. Their stronghold is heavily guarded, but I trust your resourcefulness will allow you to penetrate deep into the complex and retrieve the artifact from their vaults. Be careful of the upper level overhead. Non-flying heavy armors and tanks disallowed due to difficult terrain. Look for yellow exit tiles." By reading the text, we can see the most important tip here. Be careful of the upper level overhead. I already had this mission on my last playthrough, which I suffered some unnecessary casualties because the Cult of Apocalypse guys were just falling from the level above behind my troops. So when you're dealing with this mission, make sure you bring plenty of units that can fly. In my case, that's Galsin flying armor. Okay, I screwed up here. So we can see right here that I've screwed up and didn't pay enough attention at the requirements for armor, because some of my gals are actually in their undies. So I have 4 gals in their underwear, which means I still have plenty that's armored. And we're ready. So one thing to note here is the holes above head, so I can see one right there. But that's exactly why we got the gulls in flying suits. There's gonna be a bunch of the enemies on this floor above, and they're gonna be dropping behind your gulls if you don't take the fight to them. Now, since the area is quite dark, you can't see anything. I can't see where I'm going. I suggest using a map. Another thing I recommend is to keep to these rooms that are kind of explored, because you will have a bunch of enemies in the hallway trying to get you. And also there's always a possibility for the enemy to jump down from the holes like that and attack your gulls from behind. Now also one thing to note, at the end of this hallway there's the vault we are looking for. And in front of the vault there's gonna be one or maybe even two gun emplacements. And you wanna make sure you stay clear from the range of the gun emplacement. Alright, let's see what the enemy does. So my gal got burned. And we're gonna try and kill the imp that did that. Okay, that's it for this turn. Thank you. So I feel a bit uneasy about this position here. And obviously, Pao in the overhead layer, I'm trying to camp at the corners, because if the enemy has heavy weapons that can set me ablaze or destroy huge chunks of maps, they usually won't use them if there's only one of my units next to them. So let's see what happens. Another thing that I want to say here is that you don't want to overextend. These guys in this room are camping at this hole. So if anyone drops there, they would hopefully reaction fire and kill that person. And I'm going to explore this right now with this gull. And the next hole is right there. So anyone can drop there and attack my guys here or there. So yep, I'm actually not gonna make it to here, because you see, I would have to rush there and expose myself to the attacks from this side. And I still wanna have quite a few time units left, because if anything or anyone come next to me, I wanna be able to reaction fire with my knife. So we managed to kill quite a few of them just with reaction fire, which was great. Ouch, friendly fire, and quite nasty one. Yeah, I made a mistake, so I've used all of my TUs. Okay, let's see what happens. Luckily, they decided to rush me instead of shoot me. So I'm just gonna allow my ground troops, well, troops on the first level, to wait until the troops on the top floor catch up, because I wanna cover this hole and that hole and this hole. So that hole is fine. The downside of the fire I've caused here is that it also lets the enemy more easily spot my troops. And as I said, there's a gun emplacement at the end of the hole, so I'm not gonna rush there. So we can see here, those are the field guns. Those are the emplacements I was talking about. And this looks like a 44 mil, or was it 40? Something like that. So one of the guns is down. Luckily, something exploded over there. And that's it for this mission. So we can see that I've killed 33 enemies and I got nice score. Some of the Gauls that are not fully trained got some experience and I've got nice loot. So obviously the cannons I've destroyed were actually 25 millimeter cannons. I've got the Grimoire of Transfiguration, which was my goal. As you can see, we advanced very slowly, trying not to lose any of my Gauls. However, friendly fire made quite a bit of damage. I hope you find this video useful. If you like the content I'm making, like the video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, take care, see you soon, bye!